Sold! Your number, sir. Thank you. Lot 663, ladies and gentlemen. A poster for this house's production of Hannibal by Chalamet.
Showing here.
Do I have 10 francs? Five? Five, I am bid. Six. Do I see seven? Seven against you, sir. Seven. Eight. Eight once, selling twice. Sold! To Raoul Vicomte de Chenyi. Thank you very much, sir. Lot 664, then, ladies and gentlemen. A wooden pistol and three human skulls from the 1831 production of Robert Le Diable by Meyerbeer. 10 francs for this. Ten, I am bid. 10 francs still. 15, thank you, sir. 15, I am bid. 15 once, going twice. Sold for 15 francs. Your number, sir. Lot 665, then, ladies and gentlemen. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here.
May I commence for 20 francs? Oh, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15, then. 15, I am bid. 15, thank you, sir. Yes, 20 from you, sir. Thank you very much.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madame. 25, I am bid. 30. 30 once, going twice, sold for 30 francs. To the Vicomte de Chenyi. Thank you once again, sir.
Oi! A collector's piece indeed. Every detail exactly as she said. She often spoke of you, my friend, your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666. A chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in that famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for the new electric light, so that we may get a hint of how it may look when reassembled. Perhaps we may even frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
Shalimov's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may have already met Monsieur Firmin and
I'm
Monsieur
Andre. Monsieur Lefebvre, we are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Royer. Proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur.
Monsieur Royer, our chief repetiteur. Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return! Oh. Signor!
Sad to return to find the land we love, threatened once more by Rome's far-reaching grasp. Tomorrow we shall break the chains of Rome. Tonight rejoice, your army has come home.
Signor Pianti, our principal tenor, he does play so well opposite La Carlotta.
Gentlemen, please, if you would kindly stand to one side.
Apologies, Madame Giry. Madame Giry, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Firmin, I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
Yes, I keep asking you, Monsieur, why exactly are you retired?
We take a particular pride in the excellence of our ballets here. Who's that girl, Lefebvre?
Huh?
Yes.
Meg Giry, Madame Giry's daughter. A promising dancer, Monsieur Andre. Most promising, eh?
You, Christine Daae, concentrate, girl.
Christine, what's the matter?
Daae, glorious name.
Swedish.
Any relation to the violinist?
His daughter, I believe. Always has her head in the clouds, I'm afraid.
Hannibal's guest, the elephants of Carthage, has gone to the conquering quest, Diocese, Hannibal's friends.
attention!
Madame Giry, thank you. May I have your attention, please? For some weeks now, there have been rumors of my imminent retirement, and I am glad tonight to tell you that they are all true. And it is my great pleasure to introduce you to the two new owners of the Opéra Populaire, Monsieur Richard Fermin and Monsieur Gilles André. Gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, of course. I have experienced your greatest role, Signora.
And Signor Ubaldo Pianchi.
An honor, Signor.
Piacere. Piacere.
If I remember rightly, Alyssa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal.
È vero?
I wonder, Signora, if, well, as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition? Unless, of course, Monsieur Rayer objects.
My manager commands, eh? Monsieur Rayer?
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient, thank you.
Silenzio, per favore, silenzio.
Signora?
Maestro? Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me every so often. Promise me you'll try. On that day, that not so distant day, when you're far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me. Think of me warmly.
To courtesy.
Mademoiselle, please.
Signora, are you all right?
No. Bouquet! Where is Bouquet?
Isn't no one concerned about prima donna?
Bouquet, chief of the flies, he is responsible for this. Bouquet, my God, man, what's going on up there?
Please, monsieur, don't look at me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, monsieur, there's no one there. And if there is, well, then it must be a ghost.
It's here! The Phantom of the Opera.
Good heavens, I have never heard such insolence.
Signora, please.
These things do happen.
Right.
These things do happen. Yes. You've been here 5 minutes, eh? What do you know? See, these things do happen, huh? For the past 3 years, these things do happen. And do you stop them from happening? No. And you too, you are as bad as him, huh? These things do happen. Well, until you stop these things from happening, this thing does not happen. Ubaldo, andiamo, eh?
Oh, signora.
Ciao, signora. Oh, che dolore. Get away from here.
Amateurs.
Well, there does not seem to be anything more I can do to assist you. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
Now, signor, this one.
Signor! La Carlotta will be back, yes.
You think so, messieurs? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
Oh, God in heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house. Commands that you continue to leave box 5 empty for his use. And reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you can afford more with the Vicomte de Chenille as your patron?
Madame, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
Madame, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Dye could sing it, sir.
The chorus girl?
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From who?
I don't know, monsieur.
Oh, not you as well. A full house and we shall have to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me every so often.
Andre, this is doing nothing for my nerves.
Fret,
on that day, that not so distant day, when you are far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me. Oh.
Yes, you did well. He will be pleased. And you were a disgrace tonight. Such rendezvous, such tant de cuisse. Come, we rehearse now. Dancer, then come and practice. My dear, I was asked to give you this. A red scarf, the attic. Little Lottie.
A tour de force! No other way to describe it!
What a relief! Not a single refund!
Greedy.
Richard, I think we've made quite the discovery in Miss Dye.
Well, here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
Ooh, as you wish, monsieur.
It appears as if they've met before.
Christine Daae, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it, not after all the trouble I took. I was just 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Raoul, so it is you.
Christine.
Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too?
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls?
Or of goblins, of shoes, or of riddles, of frocks?
Those picnics in the attic, or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories of the north.
Oh, what I love best, love. head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
Father said, when I am in heaven, child, I shall send the angel of music to you. Well, Father is dead, Raoul, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
Oh, no doubt of it. And now, we go to supper.
No, Raoul, the angel of music is very strict.
Well, I shan't keep you up late.
No, Raoul, things have changed.
You must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes, little Lottie.
Raoul! Things have changed, Raoul!
Insolent boy, this slave of fashion, basking in your glory. Ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Angel, I hear you speak, I listen. Stay by my side, guide me. Forgive me, alter at last, master.
Flattering child, you shall know me. See why in shadow I hide. Look at your face in the mirror. I am there inside.
That voice. Who is that in there?
Angel of music, come to me, angel of music.
Christine! Angel!
the opera is there. And you'll
secretly possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind in this darkness which you know you cannot fight. The darkness of the music of the
Delilah, you little viper, now you can't.
cannot ever be free. Damn you! Curse you! Stranger than you dreamt it, can you even dare to look or bear to think of me? This loathsome gargoyle who burns in hell but secretly yearns for heaven. Secretly, secretly. But Christine, fear can turn to love. You'll learn to see, to find the man behind the monster. This repulsive carcass who seems a beast but secretly dreams of beauty. Secretly, secretly. Oh, Christine. Come, we must return. Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Parchment is his skin. A great black owl serves as the nose, which never grew. You must be always on your guard, or he will catch you with his magical lasso.
Those who speak of what they know find too late that prudent silence is wise. Joseph Bouquet, hold your tongue. He will burn you with the heat of his eyes.
Mystery if the gala night, it's his mystery if soprano's flight. Mystified, baffled surety, say we are mystified, we suspect foul play. Bad news on soprano scene, first Carlotta, now Christine. Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva tenders resignation, covered as a moonlight flit. Half your cast disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera! To hell with look and handle, have a scandal, and you're sure to have a hit.
Damnable! They all walk out, this is damnable!
Audrey, please don't shout, it's publicity, and the take publicity. Is fast publicity.
But we have no cast!
But Andre, have you seen the cue?
It seems you've got one, two. Dear Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Furman, just a brief reminder.
My salary has not been paid. Send it care of the ghost by return of post PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed.
Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a puerile brain.
These are both signed OG.
Who the hell is he?
Opera ghost. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre.
To expect a large retainer, nothing plainer. He is clearly quite
insane. Where is she?
You mean Carlotta?
And he's dying. Where is she?
Well, how should we know?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at her.
She's not with you then?
Of course not.
We're in the dark.
Monsieur, don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Oh, written.
Do not fear for Miss Daye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempts to see her again.
Well, if you didn't write it, then who did?
Where is he?
Welcome back.
Where is he?
What is it now?
I have a letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he were.
Didn't send it?
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the Opera Populaire are numbered. Christine Daae will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Daae's name.
Miss Daae has returned.
In which case, I think, our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing?
Will she sing? Here, I have a note.
Let me see it.
Please. Gentlemen. I have now sent you several notes of a most amiable nature, detailing...
Telling how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance. Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of Il Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy and put Miss Daae in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Daae plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these demands be ignored,
a disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Whatever next?
Christine!
This is insane!
I know who sent this! The people turn them on!
Indeed, can you believe it?
Signora! You are a star!
And always will be!
Signora!
Some man is mad!
We don't take orders!
Miss Time will be playing the page boy! The silent role!
Carlotta will be playing the lead!
The daughter is her!
It's useless trying to amaze me!
Fly from my arms.
you too.
Would you not rather have your precious little ingenue?
Signora, no. The world wants you. Prima donna, first lady of the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you.
Can you bow out when they're shouting your name?
Think of how they all adored you. Prima donna, enchant us once again.
Think of your muse
and of the queues round the theatre. Can you deny us the triumph in store? Sing prima donna once more.
Seats, we shall be sitting in box 5.
Don't you really think that wise, monsieur?
My dear André, there would appear to be no seats available other than box 5.
They say that this youth has set my lady's heart aflame.
His lordship, sir, would die of shock.
His lordship is a laughing stock.
Come here, spectacle, protect her.
Shame, shame, shame. This faithless lady's bound for Hades.
Shame, shame, shame.
Nothing like the old operas.
Or the old sex.
The old singers.
Hardly. A disaster beyond imagination.
Serafimo, your disguise is perfect. Why, who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your loving husband.
Every seed sold.
Hardly a disaster at all.
My love, I am called to England on affairs of state and must leave you with your new maid. Though I gladly take the maid with me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe her.
Perhaps it is you who are the toad.
Maestro, da capo, per favore. Serafimo, away with this pretense. You cannot speak, but kiss me in my ear. Fool, he makes me laugh.
Behold, she is beginning to bring down the chandelier.
Let's get her out of here. We need to fix this right now.
I don't.
Shall
we?
Our apologies. At the performance. We'll continue in 10 minutes' time. When the role of the Countess shall be played by Miss Christine Daae.
Go, Ralph.
Yes. Well, in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet. Yes, the ballet. Yes. From act 3 of tonight's opera. Yes. Maestro, bring the ballet forward. The ballet. Now.
Thank you.
Why have you brought us here?
Don't take me back there.
We must return.
He'll kill me. His eyes will find me there.
You see, no, say that.
Those eyes, the burden.
Don't even think it.
If he has to kill a thousand men.
This waking nightmare.
The phantom of the
this
opera.
This phantom is a fable. Believe me, there is no phantom of the opera.
My God, who is this man?
My God, who is this
who
man?
Who wants to kill? I can't escape
this
from here. I never will. And in this labyrinth, when night is blind, the phantom of the opera is here.
Inside my mind, there is no phantom of the opera.
Roy, I've been there. To his world of unending night, to a world where the daylight dissolves into darkness, darkness. Roll, I've seen him. Can I ever forget that sight? Can I ever escape from that face so distorted, deformed? Was hardly a face in that darkness, darkness. But his voice filled my spirit with a strange, sweet sound. In that night, there was music in my mind, and through music my soul began to sing. And I heard as I'd never heard.
What you heard was a dream and nothing more.
Yet in his eyes all the sadness of the world was pleading eyes that both threaten and adore.
Christine, Christine. Forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here. Nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you.
Promise me that all you say is true.
Let me be your shelter. Let me be your light. You're safe. No one will find you. Your fears are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night, and you always beside me to hold me and to hide me.
Then say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. Say you need me with you here beside you. Anywhere you go, let me go too. Christine, that's all I ask of you.
Say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Say the words and I will follow you.
Share each day with me, each night, each morning.
Denied me and betrayed me.
Monsieur Fermat?
Monsieur André!
Dear André, what a splendid party!
The prologue to a bright new year.
Quite a night, I'm impressed.
Where one does one's best.
Here's to us,
a toast to all the city.
Such a pity that the phantom can't be here!
False, who is who? Girl of lips, swell of gown, ace of hearts. face of clown.
Faces, drink it up, till you drown in the lights, in the sound.
Took a name of
masquerade. Bring a speed rest, masquerade. Take your fear at the spectacle, the sound you know.
Proud, all the creme de la creme.
Watching us and all our fears are in the
six past. 6 months
of relief.
Of Elysian peace.
We can breathe out at last.
No more ghosts.
Here's a health.
Here's a toast to a prosperous year.
To a new chandelier.
And we splendor your day.
What a blessed release and what a masquerade.
Think of it, a secret engagement. Look, your future bride, just think of it.
But why is it secret? What have we to hide?
You promised me. Look out, please don't.
Then let them see it's an engagement, not a crime. Christine, what are you afraid of?
Let's not argue. Please pretend.
I can only hope.
So silent, good messieurs. Did you think that I had left you for good? Have you missed me, good messieurs? I have written you an opera. Here I bring the finished score. Don Juan triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Remain calm.
Madam Shiri!
Monsieur, don't ask me. I know no more than anyone else.
That's not true. You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please don't ask, monsieur.
Madam, for all our sakes.
Very well. It was years ago. There was a traveling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was, I shall never forget him, a man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Oh, a prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
Composer?
And an inventor, too, monsieur. They boasted had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature. More monster than man.
Deformed?
From birth, it seemed.
My God.
And then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness
and so
I have seen him again. I have said too much, monsieur.
No, wait.
Too much, and there have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madam Shiri!
Ludicrous, have you seen the score?
Simply ludicrous.
It's the final straw.
This lunacy, well, you know my views.
Utter lunacy.
But we can't refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre, read my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and that third trombone has to go. The man cannot be deafer, so please preferably one who plays in tune.
Dear Furman, vis-a-vis my opera, some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch wisely, though, I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act.
Outrage!
Now? Signora, please!
Now what's the matter?
Help, you see the size of my palm!
Signora, listen!
It's an insult!
Love you as well!
Just look at this, it's an insult!
Please understand! Signora!
The things I have to do for my art!
If you can call this bush... gibberish art...
Here's our little flower.
Amistaye, quite the lady of the hour.
You have secured the largest role in the star one.
Christine Daye, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please.
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind this.
It appears we have no choice.
She is the one behind this, Christine Daye.
How dare you?
I am a fool.
You evil woman, how dare you?
You think I'm lying?
This isn't my fault. I don't want any part in this plot.
Miss Daye, surely.
But why not?
What does she say? It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it. Duty or not.
Christine, Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, Another note.
Oh.
Fondest greetings to you. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts. Carlotta must be
taught to act, not her normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Pianji's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Dye, no doubt she'll do her best. It's true, her voice is good. She knows, though, should she wish to excel, she has much still to learn. If pride will let her return to me, her teacher, her teacher. Your obedient friend.
And Angel. I can't. I won't do it.
We have all been blind, and yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
We're listening!
Go on.
We shall play his game, perform his work, but remember we hold the ace. For if Miss Dye sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred.
We make certain our men are penned.
We make certain their heart.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Marvelous.
I'm not so sure.
Not if it works.
This is madness.
The tide will turn.
You still believe it? There is no way. Turning the tide.
You stick to ballet.
Then help us.
But sure, I can't.
Instead of warning us,
help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses.
But could it be that you're on his side?
She's his accomplice.
Monsieur, believe me, I intend to do ill. But monsieur, be careful, we have seen.
We'll say your father, but he
will. This
is a cross.
Christine,
life.
You shall free our souls.
By fire, he'll take me, I know. We'll be parted forever. He won't let me go. What I once used to dream, I now dread. If he finds me, it won't ever end. And he'll always be there, singing songs in my head. He'll always be there, singing songs in my head. She's mad.
You said yourself he was nothing but a man. Yet while he
good, I know I can't refuse, and
yet I wish I could. Oh God, if I agree, but halls wait for me in this. The phantoms of
Christine, Christine, don't think that I don't care, but every hope and every prayer rests on you now.
Tangled with Don Juan.
No! No! Cordis, please rest. Don Juan, Signor Fianchi, this is the phrase. Those who tangled with Don Juan, if you please.
Oh. Those who tangled with Don Juan.
No. Nearly, but no. Those who tang, tang, tang.
Those who tang, tang, tang.
Oh. His way is better, no? At least he makes it sound like music.
Signora, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here, and if he were here, I would tell
him. Are you certain of that, Signora?
So, once again, Signor Fianchi after 7. 5, 6, 7.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
What is wrong? I'm trying. I'm trying again. I don't understand. There's no milk here.
Pour your maiden for the thrill of your tongue of sword and sweet.
You have to pay the bill.
You have to pay the bill. Tangled in the winding sheets.
Thank you. little Lottie thought of everything and nothing. Her father promised her that he would send her the angel of music. Her father promised her. Her father promised her.
Speak, what endless longings! yet your soul.
Of darkness, cease this torment! Christine, listen to me! Whatever you think, whatever you may believe, this man, this thing is not your father! Let her go, for God's sake, let her go! Christine!
Ralph!
Bravo, monsieur! Such spirited words!
More tricks, monsieur!
Let's see, monsieur, how far you dare go!
More deception? More violence?
That's right, that's right. Keep walking this way.
You cannot win her love by making her your prisoner.
I'm here, the angel of death. Come on, monsieur, don't stop. So be it. Now let it be war upon you.
Positions. I shall then instruct you to secure the doors. It is essential that all doors are secured properly.
Are we doing the right thing, André?
Have you got a better idea?
Monsieur le Vicomte, friend, am I to give the order?
Give the order. You, in the pit, do you have a clear view of box 5?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. Only if you have to. But shoot to kill.
But how will I know, sir?
You'll know.
Are you sure this is going to work, Monsieur le Vicomte?
Don't worry, my dear Fermat. André?
We're in your hands, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Are the doors secure?
I'm here, the phantom of the opera. I'm here, the phantom of the opera.
I'm here! Idiot! You'll kill someone! I said not until the time comes.
But, Monsieur le Vicomte?
No buts! For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right. Seal my fate tonight. I hate to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin. Let the audience in. Let my opera begin.
Hear the sirens through the dam, hear the master's kisses meet, hear the sacrificial lamb, answers one despairing plead. For your maiden, for the thrill on your tongue, your solid sweet. You will have to pay the bill.
Sarina, faithful friend, once again recite the plan.
Your young spirits are now, I don't master you the man.
When you met, you wore my cloak, she could not have seen your face. She believes she dines with me in a master's borrow place. For Tivoli will scoff and puff, stealing what in the truth is mine when it's late, and modesty starts to mellow with the wine.
You come home, I use your voice, slam the door like crack of doom.
I shall say, come hide with me, where, oh where, of course, of my room.
Poor thing hasn't got a chance.
Here's my hat, my cloak and sword, conquest is assured, if I do not forget myself and love.
No thoughts within our head, but thoughts of joy. No dreams within our heart, but dreams of love.
Master Asarino, go away for the trap is set and waits for its prey. You have come here in a pursuit of your deepest urge, in a pursuit of that wish which till now has been silent. Silent. I have brought you that our passions may fuse and emerge. In your mind you've already succumbed to me, dropped all defenses, completely succumbed to me. Now you are here with me. Second thoughts, you've decided. Decided. Past the point of no return, no backward glances, our games of make-believe are at an end. Past all thought of if or when, no use resisting, abandon thought and let the dream descend. What a raging fire shall flood the soul, what rich desire unlocks the door, what sweet seduction lies before. Past the point of no return, the final threshold, what warm unspoken secrets will we learn? Beyond the point of no return.
Second thoughts, I've decided. out of right or wrong. One final question.
But the wickedness of my abhorrent face.
Oh, found this murderer, he must be found.
Hounded out by everyone, met with hatred everywhere. No kind word from anyone, no compassion anywhere. Christine! Christine, why? Why?
Your hand at the level
at
of your
the level
eyes.
Of your eyes.
At the level of your eyes.
He lives across the lake, monsieur. And this is as far as I dare go.
Madame Giry, thank you.
Track down this murderer, he must be found. Track down this murderer, he must be found. Hunt down this animal who runs to ground. Too long he's preyed on us, but now we know.
Have you gorged yourself at last in your lust? for blood. Am I now to be prey to your lust for flesh?
That fate which condemns me to wallow in blood has also denied me the joys of the flesh. This face, the infection which poisons our love. This face which turned a mother's fear and loathing, a mask, my first unfeeling scrap of clothing. Pity comes too late. Turn around and face your fate, an eternity of this before your eyes.
This haunted face holds no home for me now. It's in your soul that the true distortion lies.
Ah, wait. I think, my dear, we have a guest. Sir, this is indeed an unparalleled delight. I'd rather hope that you would come. And now, my wish comes true. You have truly made my night.
Free her. Do what you like, only free her. Have you no pity?
Your lover makes a passionate plea.
Please, Robert, you.
I love her. Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion.
The world show no compassion to me.
Christine, Christine, let me see her.
Be my guest, sir.
Christine.
Mercy, I bid you welcome. Did you think that I would harm her? Why should I make her pay for the sins which I done? Oh, you fine horses now, raise up your hands to the level of your eyes. Nothing can save you now, except perhaps Christine. Start a new life with me. Buy his freedom with your love. Refuse me and you'll send your lover to his death. This is the choice. This is the point of no return.
The tears I might have shed for your dark fate grow cold and turn to tears of hate.
Christine, forgive me, please forgive me. I did it all. Him to his grave. I make her
return.
You deceived me. I gave my mind blindly.
Patience.
Make your choice.
Pity our creature of darkness. What kind of life have you won? God, give me courage to show you.
Christine.